of you try and think on your own, how would you solve this question? This is from S.C. Verma book. Some of you might have seen it. So what are things given here? This is given a small plain strip suspended from fixed support to a string of length L. So this is string here, length of the string is L. A continuous beam of light is incident horizontally. So light is incident horizontally, it means momentum also is coming horizontally. So it is equivalent to something is striking, and the momentum also, if I write a momentum here, momentum will be in the horizontal direction. It strikes the surface and gets completely absorbed. So it is not getting reflected back. So whatever momentum after striking becomes zero, that's why there is a change in momentum. So what is change in momentum will be equal to? Change in will be equal to actually negative of initial momentum. Final momentum minus initial momentum, and final momentum is zero. So change in momentum is in the opposite sense. Okay, absorbed. And we are more concerned about change in momentum. Change in momentum will be equal to initial momentum. That's what it is. Let's see what else is given. Energy falling on the strip per unit time is W. What we call energy per unit time is like power. Find the deflection of the stream from the vertical if mirror stays in equilibrium. So it makes an angle theta, it remains, mirror remains. It's not a mirror, it's a surface which absorbs the light completely. If the strip deflects slightly from equilibrium from the plane mirror, what is the time period? Okay, so in this case, how would you solve? So whenever light falls onto the surface, it gets absorbed. There is a change in momentum, it will exert a force. So what is the force exerted on?
W by C.
On the strip. What is the force exerted on the strip? By incident light. And force will be because of force is equal to rate of change of momentum. It will be equal to delta P by delta T. It will be equal to change in momentum. And what is momentum equal to in terms of light? Momentum is in terms of light. Momentum is equal to what is momentum? How do we relate momentum to? What is momentum in case of light? Momentum is H by lambda. If we multiply by C, we get equal to is energy of incident light divided by C. Divided by frequency. So momentum is equal to energy by C. And if you divide by time, so what is force equal to? Force equal to rate of change of momentum. So force is equal to change in momentum divided by time. And what is change in momentum here? Incident momentum itself is equal to change in momentum. I hope it, when it gets absorbed, it finally becomes zero. What incident momentum is equal to energy by C into time. And what is this term? And if, so what are things which are given here? This is the force. Where, which energy are we talking about here? What does this energy mean here? Since we are calculating force on the strip, this energy also energy which is incident on the strip in a given time. Energy in given by time, this is energy incident on the strip in a unit time, that is power which is incident on the surface divided by C. That's the force. And this is directly given here. Power value is given as falling is W. So force is equal to W by C. So this is applying up. It is equivalent to, and can we calculate angle it will make here? So this, it will exert a force on the mirror. This is the force it will exert. This will force due to light. And it is making an angle alpha here. So how do we calculate theta here? Some of you recall, how would I calculate if this is, what a force is acting? How would it, so we need to calculate here, find the deflection, find theta. How would you find theta here? What principle we'll use to find theta here? Whenever it calculates, how do you find theta, anyone?
And theta equals Fi by Fg.
No, see, if I ask you, which principle do we find theta based on, which principle do we find it on? Basically, we consider the equilibrium of this strip here. So based on Newton's law of motion, if I draw, if I take this as an object, this is a system, then we identify what are the forces acting. The forces acting, if I draw the free body diagram of the strip, what are the forces acting on the strip? Its weight is acting downwards, mg. And force exerted by the light, this is this force is acting in this direction, and tension is acting at angle theta. This is how it is, the tension and this length. And we need to find this angle theta here. There are two ways of solving. I can write equation sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0. Or other way to understand, if I take the vector sum of these two, vector sum of f and mg will be equal and opposite to theta. If I take the vector sum of these two, this sum of vector sum will also make an angle theta. If I take vector sum of f and mg, this is the right angle triangle getting formed, and tan theta will be equal to horizontal force divided by vertical weight. So what is tan theta equal to? Tan theta is equal to f by mg. And what is f is equal to? F is equal to f by c into mg. That's the tan theta. And this f is equal to w by c. Okay, this theta. So this is, it will remain in equilibrium. And in this case, suppose I, next question, if I ask, what is the tension in the string? What is the tension in the string here? This is the tan theta. So what are forces acting? This, let me ask, what is the tension in this case? How much tension will act in the string? Shreya, can you tell me what is the tension which will act in the string here? How much, what this tension will be equal to? Shreya?
Yes, sir.
How much will be the tension in the string here? How would you calculate this value of T?
T cos theta will be mg, right, sir?
T cos theta is equal to mg. That is the one way I have to calculate. Then in that case, I have to again substitute theta value. Or other way of thinking about what is T equal to? T is equal to vector sum of f and mg, equal and opposite. And what is vector sum of f and g? They are at right angle. So I can write T f cup. What you said is also right. T cos theta is equal to mg. I could have written two equations. T cos theta is equal to mg. And I could have written T sine theta is equal to f. And that case, what I'll do, first question, if I want an answer without term theta, I will square the first equation plus the second equation square. If I square this term, it will come cos square theta sin square theta. It comes equal to T square is equal to mg whole square plus f square. Or I can do otherwise also. So this is a term. So tension is equal to root of mg plus w by c. This is tension. What it says, it is in the state of equilibrium. But if you give a small oscillation, it will start oscillating. It will have angular SHM. It will have SHM motion. How do you find out time period of SHM? Can anyone think of a method of finding time period? And to give a hint here, see what happens in case of normal pendulum. In case of normal pendulum, when you suspend, mass M is suspended. So weight is acting downwards. And tension force is acting here. So here the tension is equal to mg. In case of vertical, tension is equal to mg. The value of g is what? G is equal to T by m. So similar way, in this case, if I have to find what is the equivalent value of g, how should I find equivalent g in this case? Can you think of, this is what mg is. Mg is what I have taken as g as. The formula for time period is equal to 2 pi root L by. So I was thinking, can we apply a similar formula here with this small modification? In this case, it will be time period will be equal to 2 pi L by some other value of G. It will not be same G. What is the effective G? Can you think of what is the effective G we can use here? What is the effective G we can use here? How did you find g here? If I compare this equation, I find the value of g here by dividing t by m. So here also I found the value of t. I can find effective g value is equal to t by m. But sorry, my bad here. I have not squared here. This system has to be squared. And this is T1. So this is something, can we find effective G now? Effective G, so if I do TY, so it will become equal to M square G square plus W square by C square, whole thing divided by M square. It will become equal to root of G square plus W square C square by M square. Or I can write as effective G is equal to G and whole thing within root 1 plus W square C square by M square G square. That's the value of G I can use. Advay? Yes?
How
do we get
T equals mg, sir?
See, normal pendulum. See, what I am relating, we are relating it to what has happened here. See, this is something effectively why it has become inclined rather than force mg acting here. Some other forces started acting. What other forces started acting? The forces started acting something like this. So is it kind of extrapolation? Can I draw a similarity between this and this? And if I draw a similarity, see, only thing what has become, here force was acting mg, hence the tension also was equal to mg. Here effectively, the other than force which was vertical, it has become inclined and magnitude also has changed. Hence, this is the orientation. So is if I look, if I tilt my head at an angle theta, does this arrangement look similar to this? Do we see similarity between these two?
Well, since that is the equilibrium position.
That's the equilibrium position. And also in equilibrium position, why it is shifted? So see, just think of it. If I keep my head vertical, I see like this. If I might tilt my head at an angle theta, this also okay. We see like this. And we can derive that one also. But I think rather than going for derivation, that's another way we can use G effective. And that's a quick way of solving, finding time period whenever equilibrium is not in vertical condition. So this is a quick method. In a way, it is a shortcut method. I'm not giving a proof, and you can arrive at the proof also. But since we are not at the topic of SHM, we are doing a topic of matter wave and just relating it to how we can find effective value of G. This becomes something like this. And it is valid in many cases. I can give one more example. What is the other example we can give? We can use it somewhere else also. And again, let me see that case. Suppose I have a string, a mass is suspended from a string. The mass is suspended. Let's say this is whole thing is mounted on a car or a trolley, and this is given a horizontal acceleration of say something like g by root 3. If I give an horizontal acceleration g by root 3, what will be the equilibrium position of this pendulum? Will it remain vertical? It will not remain vertical. What will be the equilibrium position? How do you find out what is the angle this pendulum will make in equilibrium? What is the angle it will make? How do you find this angle theta here?
30 degrees.
Yeah, but how do you find? Can you tell me what are the, actually we can find in two ways. What are the two ways we can find out? How do you find angle theta? See, will this this be in equilibrium? Will this mass be in equilibrium? Only if the person who is standing inside this trolley, if the person is standing in the trolley, to him it will appear at in equilibrium. But any person who is standing outside, this also will be having an acceleration equal to g by root 3. So this mass m, as seen from ground, will have an acceleration equal to acceleration of the trolley. But if I observe from a frame of reference which is within the trolley, then it will appear in a state of equilibrium. So this question, first way of a look at this, from a frame of reference, which is with trolley. So which also has same acceleration, frame of reference also has an acceleration of g by root 3. In this frame, it is in the state of equilibrium. I'm just a little bit quick revision of laws of motion. So in that case, it will appear in equilibrium. But since in this case, this frame of reference has an acceleration, we need to apply a pseudo force. What is the pseudo force we apply? We apply a force which is not a real force. We apply to make Newton's law applicable from non-initial frame of reference. So in that case, the forces acting on the pendulum will become something like this. Forces acting in the pendulum will be equal to mg here. That's a real force. The tension here. And there's also pseudo force. How much is the pseudo force? It is opposite to direction of acceleration, root 3. And now I can apply condition of equilibrium. And when we apply this equilibrium, it will remain in the state of equilibrium at 30 degrees. But even here also, if we give slight displacement, it will have oscillation. What is the time period of oscillation in this case? What is the time period of oscillation? Arish, can you tell me what is the time period of oscillation of a pendulum of length L, which is accelerated in the horizontal direction with an acceleration of g by root 3? Arish, can you tell me what is the time period?
I'm not sure, sir.
Not sure? Can we have done something similar? See, in this case also, can you tell me what is the tension force which will be acting on the string in this case? Can you calculate tension here?
Yes, sir.
Let's see. First, let me first break down. First part, what is the tension in the string? Tell me what is the tension in the string here in this case? How much will be the tension here? It will be square of this. Plus square of this whole square root. Are we okay with that point? The tension will be equal to sum of these two forces and opposite in direction. So tension in the string will be equal to root of mg square plus mg by root 3 whole square, which will be equal to mg root of 1 plus 1 by 3 equal to 2mg by root 3. That will be the tension. If this is the tension, what I can take as effective G? Effective G, one way of making shortcut, effective G is equal to tension by M. What is effective G in this case? Effective G can be taken as 2G by root 3. In that case, time period will become equal to 2 pi root of L by G effective, which becomes equal to 2 pi root L root 3 by. Bhagyashree?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting any of it?
Yes, sir.
This is something, as you said, slight diversion. This topic is not, we are not talking about not more of a matter wave. It's a matter wave. I say this is okay. So questions may be related to some of the topic related to first year. That's how we can calculate. What is the other way? If can we suppose I want to find tension, I have this way, I have used pseudo force. Can we find this tension from the ground frame of reference, which we call as the initial frame of reference? How would I solve this question, initial frame of reference? If I draw from initial frame of reference, this free body diagram, this mass M will have vertical downward force mg acting, and it will have a force, tension force acting at angle theta, and this object will have same as seen from the ground. If it is in equilibrium with respect to the trolley, it will have same acceleration as acceleration of trolley. So if I draw the free body diagram, if I take the component here, it will become equal to something like this. It will become, this will be mg, it will be equal to t cos theta, and this will be equal to t sine theta. I am just doing slowly. And what will be my equation of motion? Equation of motion will be equal to summation of forces in x direction is equal to max, and summation of force in y direction is equal to may. So in this case, it has only in horizontal direction, vertical direction, no acceleration. So summation of force in fy is equal to 0 will give me t cos theta is equal to mg. That's one equation. And what is the second equation if I write here? T sine theta is equal to m in. What is the acceleration? जी बाई रूट थ्री. सो इफ आई सब्स्टिट्यूट एम जी इक्वल टू टी कॉस थीटा I can find what is the tan theta. Tan theta is equal to 30 degree, and I can find same thing. So this question can be solved using both the approaches. So I hope some of you followed. Jadeep, have you followed this?
Yes, sir.
And both the frame of reference. Are you understanding what is the frame of reference? You can solve if a person is standing inside the trolley, it will not move with respect to the person. Whereas if you see from the ground, it will this also will appear to be moving with the same acceleration as the trolley acceleration.
Yes, sir.
One more thing I thought I'll discuss, not in terms of theory. All of you assume that you have an LED bulb kind of thing. So suppose there's a bulb here. I'll come back to the light. See, suppose there's a bulb here, and it could be an LED bulb, and bulb has something like it emits radiation. Of something like it is 20 watt bulb. See, but you would have noticed if you observe from a near distance, it appears very bright, and if you observe from far, it does not appear so bright. It will look appear much brighter here, and it will appear less brighter here. Can you think of what is the which physical quantity is the brightness of the bulb related to? And if you go very far, it will appear very dim. Actually, sometimes it will barely be noticeable. And this is very, I think we can all can relate to. This is what we can actually experience. If we suppose we have a dark room, you light the bulb, you see from close distance, it will appear very bright. You will have a different sensation. As you move far, it will have a less brightness. But what is this brightness term related to? Can you think of
density?
Density. And so basically, the observed brightness depends on what? Observed brightness is proportional to intensity. And actually, the reason why I see it is what the rays are entering the eye and it creating a sensation. So suppose if I take this distance, suppose it is 1 meter and this distance is 4 meter. Okay. And if I say, and even eye also has a kind of particular opening. It has a small opening through which the rays enter. It falls onto your retina. Let's assume for just sake of saying this opening of eye or radius of the eye opening, iris, is equal to say 5 mm. If I ask this question, find the energy entering the eye when in first case, when you are at point A, what is the energy which enters your eye in 1 second, which is nothing but power? How much energy will enter your eye in 1 second when you are at A? How do you calculate how much energy is entering? And there we are making some assumption. What is the assumption we are making? I am facing the bulb. Eye is surface of the eye. Opening of the eye is perpendicular to the surface line joining the bulb and the eye. Can you calculate the energy here? How many can calculate energy entering the eye in 1 second? Can you calculate the energy? And then I can extend the question. I can extend the question. If bulb is yellow in color, if lambda is equal to say 40, lambda is equal to say 620, 413 nanometer. How many photons enter the eye in 1 second? How many can answer these two questions? What is the energy entering the eye in 1 second? How would you calculate? Can you relate some term? How would I, which form, how would I write this term equation as? Dhanshi, can you write the first expression?
Yes, sir.
What is the energy entering the eye in 1 second?
So we know that power is equal to energy per unit time, so we can equate those two.
Energy entering the eye. Okay, can you write an expression? Can you tell me in terms of this is given as 20 watt? Let's write if the power of the bulb is P. So in terms of P, and this distance is D, and radius of I is R. Can you tell me an expression in terms of P, D, and R? What is the energy entering the eye in terms of power of the bulb, distance of I from the bulb, and radius of the eye? All of you can, one by one, I'll ask others of you. But this is something, can we find, if we can answer this one, then we have understood a little bit about intensity. What is the expression of energy entering the eye in 1 second?
Just give me a second, sir.
That is, please try. Go through and see which we have understood that part or not. Tejas Imidi, can you tell me, can you calculate what is the energy entering the eye in 1 second? Which is same as power. Power in, remember, power entering the eye. The same thing I could have written if I use some other words. If I ask, what is the power entering the eye? Which is also same thing, power entering the eye. In that case, I don't have to write 1 second, but answer the same. Power entering the eye. Tejas, can you tell me? Can you write an expression in terms of power is P, I is at a distance of D, and radius of I is R. What is the expression of this term? Tejas, not clear? Hemant?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me? Can you tell me the expression?
Intensity would be equal to power by area.
Okay, tell me what is the intensity. Intensity at which point? I have to calculate intensity where I is it not?
Yes.
The intensity, so basically I am looking at intensity at the position of I, where the I is. And I can define the position of I, or I can say, either I can say intensity is the position of I, then only I can calculate energy entering, or I can say intensity at distance D. What is intensity at distance D? What is the expression for intensity at distance D? Power source is P, Eman?
P by A, 4 pi A.
D square.
D square.
This is intensity. So their intensity is so. So basically what intensity means? Intensity means if area is one unit, energy entering per energy falling on a unit area which is perpendicular to this line will be equal to per unit time is I. But here area is not one unit. Time is 1 second, but area is not one. So what is the energy falling? What is the power on area A? Power on area A. What is the power on area A? This is intensity into A into cos theta. But if the cos theta is equal to 1, power is equal to I into A.
Okay.
What should I write here? Area? Area is pi R square. So pi this R. term will be equal to P divided by 4 pi D square into pi.
And we get the answer for the second question also.
Yes. Then how many photons entering? If this is the energy, that
total
that
energy
N into energy
will be equal to energy of each photon, individual photon, and into the number of photons.
So what is happening here, as we go farther and farther, number of photons, energy of photon entering each photon, if it is monochromatic source, energy of photon will be same, but number of photons is striking our eye will become less and less. And you know, eye has a particular sensitivity. If intensity is too low, our eyes cannot sense it. And that's why I hope that you get an idea of what does intensity mean. And what happens if we turn our view sideways? Our eye is not facing the light. If we turn sideways, again, intensity would what happen? In that case, cos theta will not be.
Cos theta.
If we, depending on which, if we turn our eye by 30 degree, if we turn our eye by 30 degree, the cos theta will become, will change. Dhanshree, have you followed this point now?
Yes, sir. I have.
Okay. So this is what happened. And as we keep going farther and farther, the appearance of an object depends on intensity of the light. That's why the light is intensity is important. What we observe, the appearance of any object, we see any object as collection of several points. And that intensity coming from a point gives us how clearly we see an object, the brightness. Okay. Coming to something like this. Let's see this, I figure out this question here. A point source is placed in the center of curvature. and hemispherical surface, it is curvature P. Inner surface is completely reflecting. Find the force on the hemisphere due to light. Okay. So before I do question, I think I'll do a simpler question. I'll do a simpler question again. And let's see what my question is. My question is something like this. Suppose we have a source of light. This source of light has power P. If I keep a small area, this is small area, this radius is small r, and small r is, and this distance is capital R. Small r is much, much less than capital R, and this axis of disk so it is kept in this, is the plane of this disk is perpendicular. Can you calculate, now let's find various terms. Find energy incident on the disk. It's a circular disk of radius r. What is energy incident on the disk in time delta t? In time delta t, what is the energy incident on the disk? Can you calculate? Then we can calculate, find the energy. Then we can calculate, find impulse exerted, and assume the surface is absorbing surface. It is completely absorbing the light. Find the impulse exerted by light on disk in time delta t. Then third thing, what we'll find force exerted on disk, and finally find pressure exerted on the disk. So can all of you calculate all these four terms here? Karthike?
Yes, sir.
Can you find all the terms here?
Yes, I'm doing it, sir.
But see, even before, are you clear? Do you think you can find or not sure?
Sir, for energy, we find intensity. Uh-huh. And we multiply.
So see, one thing what we know, I think what you're saying is starting with the term intensity. If I find intensity, let me see, can all items I can start calculating intensity? What is the intensity? Intensity, I think all of you can easily calculate. What is intensity? Intensity is P divided by 4 pi r squared. So once I get this intensity, can I calculate what is the energy incident disk on time delta t in terms of I?
Yes, sir. I is E by 4 pi r squared into delta t.
Into delta t. So intensity into area into time. Because intensity is energy by area into time. So if you multiply area and time, I get energy. Is it not? Energy is what? Intensity is energy per unit area per unit time. So to get energy, I need to multiply area and time. In this case, area will be equal to, so intensity into pi r square dt. What is impulse exerted by the light on the disk? How would you calculate next one? So this is something, this is energy incident. This is E term. This is energy incident on the surface and is getting absorbed. How do we calculate impulse once I have energy? Shriya, can you tell me the impulse now? We have calculated energy incident and time delta t. And energy impulse is equal to energy. What is happening? See, this light is falling, momentum is falling, and momentum is getting completely absorbed here. So what is this impulse exerted? How would I calculate impulse exerted?
It's energy divided by C, right?
Energy divided by C. So this is directly energy divided by C. This is impulse exerted. That is the impulse exerted by on this delta t. So this becomes energy into c, which will be equal to I into pi r square delta t by c. How do you find force now? Once you found the impulse, how do you find force? What will force be equal to?
We divide it by delta t.
Divide by delta t. So what is the force equal to? Intensity into area by c. What is intensity to area called? Power incident. Power by c. The power which is incident on the surface, not this power here. Okay. And what is the pressure? If I divide by c pressure, it becomes I by c becomes pressure. So pressure is equal to I by c. So if I keep the disc at a nearer point, the pressure will be more. If I take this disc further away, pressure will be less. So these are things, if you relate all four, I think you'll have a better understanding of four related terms. What is energy, then what is impulse, what is force, and then what is pressure. And if it is getting reflected, which are the terms will change? Energy incident will not change. Impulse term will become equal to twice of this. Impulse exerted because, and force also become twice and pressure also become twice. So, and this is the one. So far we have covered the basics of matter wave. So tomorrow we don't have a class. So when we meet on Tuesday, we'll do some more application or something like this. What we can try, and few other questions related to matter wave on the similar concept. And some of you can very quickly answer. Can anyone answer this question quickly in about a minute's time, very quickly? What would be the net force exerted? Can have done something similar in the past? So pressure is easy to calculate. What is the pressure here? Pressure is equal to, if it is completely reflecting, is 2I by C is equal to pressure. If I know the pressure, can I calculate what is the force? In the radius, what is the force which will act? And we have done something similar before. So does anyone recall?